tank all the way.
I'm going slow just because there's so much cake on
it. No, we're fine. All right, ready?
All right, so we just got stuck on a dirt road. Like, literally just on the dirt road we were stuck. So, I got bummed. Almost started crying. It was going to be a man cry, not like baby cry. Chris said, we got to stay positive. So, we laced our boots and started hiking through all that mud on the road. Literally on the road. Went to the nearest farmer. He hopped in his International. Pulled us out backwards like nothing. Like it wasn't even muddy. He turned around to the muddy field. And now you can hear all that mud coming off our truck. Just caking the fender wells. Oh, now we're back on route to go look at the cards in Iowa. So, rule number Iowa. Don't turn down any road that says maybe impassable or not maintained. Avoid all those roads altogether. Don't even think about it. We're back on track and we're gonna stay on high ground and walk wherever we need to go. It's just walk. Even if it takes 2 miles, we're gonna walk there. Are we going the right way?
Yeah, turn right.
Okay, stop.
Is it recording? Can you see good or no?
Yeah, now I can.
Alright, so we just rolled up to the spot here in Iowa after a little fiasco. Just gonna pull some cards, see what's on them. And have a long drive still to Nebraska, so we'll have a lot of time to organize and check out all the shooters and stuff. Should be good. There should be some studs on it. Ready? Got the keys? That's a good sign.
Close, man. Get up close. Bingo. $1.75 is so cheap compared to Wyoming. We just need to put a coat of wax on it.
Time's it.
Time to go buck hunting.
What time is it really?
I don't know, I just woke up.
It's 5:30 in the morning.
Buck hunting time.
It's almost buck hunting time.
We got a long ways to go yet. We're still in Iowa. Made it to Nebraska. We're all geared up, ready to try to find some bucks. Got our tags, got our bows in the back, in a case, of course. And the FMJs, ready to rock. Grab the bow. I'll put my vest on for sure. It's chilly. Truck, and then we're gonna hit the P
piece across from the house with a silo, and there's two ditches there. We're gonna hit that and then come back here and hit the other side of the hill, and then try this gold piece.
Test.
You know? Yeah, these two. This one and the one directly across. We're trying to find bucks in.
There's a deer way over here. Way up on the top the ridge. Oh, I just lost it. Oh, right there. Right on the corner edge, way over here.
Sorry, I didn't mean to wake you up. I just wanted you to see it.
That's right, we saw one. It's good.
I got excited.
There's another buck to the right, right here, close.
Oh yeah, there's a buck right behind this cover.
What is it?
I'll shoot it.
Really? Should we move the truck? I think they're gonna come out on this Milo, and then maybe if they're in the Milo, we could walk down this two track.
I say we just get ready and they'll walk right by. As long as we're not moving, they're not gonna care about the truck.
It all came together. Got me a buck right next to the truck. So after I shot this one, Chris spotted a good one, and we're gonna get on it in the morning. Hopefully it all comes together.
They're just
Nebraska, and we've been cruising around since daylight. We did a lap around the block, spotted some bucks, but nothing too good.
That's a little dude.
It's still a deer though. Can you see it?
Yeah,
it looks straight. We're just trying to get it with you. Oh yeah, dude, he's nice. And he's tall. He's like as tall as the one Brian killed.
Gold mailbox. You know he's a badass with gold mailbox. Go up.
Public piece now. We've been running on private ground. We're just gonna see what's going on with it, see if there's any bucks on it. Just kind of sneak around, only spend, you know, maybe an hour, maybe 2 hours. Hopefully we can just get through it. And then it's 4 o'clock right now. So after we do that, we're gonna head back over to where we have permission to hunt and kind of sit and glass and see what the bucks are doing in the afternoon. Hopefully get a game plan going later, but that's what we're gonna do right now.
We're headed in for the afternoon setup. It's 5:30. Got dark about 7:30 last night. Travis shot his buck like 6:30. So we're going to where we saw those little bucks and one pretty good buck that I shoot, so we're gonna get up in here and glass and get set up and see what rolls in and make a move on them or just let them come to us. So see what happens. Set up in the corn again like last night, and we're hoping to catch one of these bucks just moving through this little pinch point. And the last morning in Nebraska, and then we're packing everything up and headed to Wyoming. So I'm really hoping we can make something happen real quick right here. I really think we'll be able to connect with one right here. Last morning, yesterday morning, we saw a real good buck cross right here at like 40 yards. So hopefully the same thing, and we'll be ready. Thank you.
He's looking away too.
Yeah.
Got it. So if he cuts up, if he goes into the blind well,
Chris has him bedded. I'm gonna move in. We're gonna try to get him on video. So let's put the stock on him. It's a long ways across this cornfield.
Nice work, dude.
4 yards. And I was like, oh, there's a hoof. It was like 4 yards.
Look at those eye guards.
Cool.
First muley bark. Dang, I'll remember that forever.